Андрей, на меня, пожалуйста.
Oui, il m'en manque un qui était là et je ne sais pas où il est passé. Bonjour.
Good morning.
Mesdames et messieurs,
ladies
bonjour.
And gentlemen, good morning. We're going to begin this press conference
du film en compétition, le film russe de la compétition Léviathan.
Russian film Leviathan in the official selection. Before I introduce everyone at the table, I would like to draw your attention to the issue of translation. Everything said in Russian will be translated by Odile into French, and then you will have an English version in simultaneous translation.
En revanche, je vais demander, je le ferai aussi en russe, est-ce que les questions qui sont dans la salle soient le moins possible en russe. Posez vos questions en français ou en anglais, le moins possible en russe, parce que ça va retarder la traduction.
Please opt for English or French, otherwise if it's in Russian, it will slow things down.
It will be translated into French and then it will be translated simultaneously into English. But for those who speak Russian, please ask the questions, if it's possible, in French or in English, and not in Russian, otherwise it will be longer. Thank you very much. Пожалуйста, как можно меньше вопросов на русском языке, а то это будет сложно потом с переводом. Et donc, je commence la présentation.
So I'd like to begin by introducing the people here. We have Sergei Melkumov, who is the executive producer of the film.
Je vais de l'autre côté de la table
on the other end of the table, we have the chief of photography,
Michael Kretschmann,
who is now working on his fourth film with the director.
Juste à la droite de Monsieur Kretschmann, vous avez
to his left, you will have recognized
ville,
the mayor
Roman
of the city,
Madianov.
Roman Madianov.
Juste à côté, le fameux
next
ami
to him,
amant,
we
Monsieur
have
Vladimir
the friend Vladimir of Dovidenchenkov.
Nous revenons par ici et je vous présente le mari.
I would like
Alexei
to introduce the husband, Alexei Serebryakov.
Le producteur du film,
the producer of the film,
qui un grand producteur russe et qui
a very great Russian producer, who produces films of different types, Alexander Rodnyansky.
Et enfin,
last but not least, we have Andrei Zvintsintsev.
I beg your pardon.
I was keeping her for the end. We have Elena Lyadova.
Elena Lyadova
already appeared in the film Elena. If you don't know that, she dubbed Marie Bonneby in Russian in the film The Banishment. It's her third film with Andrei. Last point for your questions, please stand up, raise your hand, introduce yourself, and use a microphone, because without a microphone there can be no translation. I'm going to ask the first question to Mr. Zviagin. Before I give the floor to the journalist, is this a metaphor of Russian society? Is that why you decided to make Leviathan? Or is it Leviathan that made you think of Russian society?
Что было в начале? Сначала история напомнила. Я правильно понимаю вопрос?
Или Левиатан?
Что было в начале? Левиатан
или общество?
Ну, в начале было слово, как известно.
У commencement était le verbe.
История.
Well, to begin with was the word.
Совершенно случайно, просто за столом в разговоре с переводчицей в 2008 году на съемках.
In 2008, in a conversation with an actor, when I was shooting a short film,
моя знакомая просто рассказала историю, которая случилась в 2004 году в Америке, в штате Колорадо. Главного героя, действующего этой истории, зовут Марвин Джон Химейер. В сети его изобретение назвали «Килдозер». Это человек, который сел на бульдозер и снес там несколько административных зданий в ответ на то, что власть не хотела считаться с его правом.
A friend told me the story of a man, Marvin, who lived in Colorado and who rose up against power and the power of a company that wanted to expropriate him from his garage and his house. He leapt onto a tractor called a killdozer and destroyed a certain number of public buildings before committing suicide. This story could have taken place anywhere in the world. But for me, there is nothing closer to my heart than Russia.
И очень скоро стало понятно, что у этого сюжета есть протосюжет, самый древний, может быть. Это история бедного Иова.
So we set the story in Russia, in a place we were familiar with. We realized there was a kind of a proto-subject, the story of poor Job. Hence Leviathan, which is referred to in the last part of the book of Job. First of all, you see the fate of human beings, and then the title occurred to us. Thank you very much. I don't speak Russian, so I'll put my question in French.
Vous instillez de l'humour.
You add humor to a film that is anything but a comedy. We weren't accustomed to this with your previous films. Why did you choose to set things in this way? As it's a real story that is set in the modern world, the film was actually shot just last summer.
Вино надо разбавить. Разбавить шуткой, потому что иначе будет слишком трагично.
Often, the Greeks, when they drank wine, added water so it wouldn't be too strong. And when you have something tragic, you have to add a little something of a comedy to make it less tragic.
Просто так живет человек, так он устроен. Мне кажется, очень точные реплики.
This was not a prior decision to mix comedy with tragedy. However, in every human life, you have these two aspects.
Я слышал уже, что иностранная аудитория, люди, которые не знакомы с нюансами, очень живо реагировали и смеялись. Я
I'm very pleased indeed to hear, and I learnt this morning just after the screening. I was very pleased to hear from foreign spectators that they laughed on many an occasion. I was very pleased to hear that. That's how the film was born. It was totally spontaneous.
Bonjour, Arnaud Schwartz.
I work at La Croix.
Bonjour, Andrei.
Good morning, Andrei. And thank you for this wonderful film, which is incredibly powerful and deep. It deals with a wealth of issues. And I'm sure that and I say we because we heard the reactions in the room, I think we were very moved. In the film, there is a dialogue between a religious figure and the husband. You refer to the book of Job, a biblical episode. This isn't the first time, I think, that you refer to the book of Job. Why are you so attached to this part of the Bible?
Bonjour, monsieur. Nice to meet you. Почему? Я не знаю. Я уже в начале рассказал о том, что очень скоро после того, как мы стали искать у этой истории, что ли, исток ее, да, семя, и наткнулись на текст.
Ну, то есть не наткнулись на текст, а вспомнили о том, что...
Of course, I've talked about the origins of this film.
Не пересказ сюжета. Это как бы сказать, такая отправная точка.
And I don't think I've simply retold the story. It's the starting point for the story. When I wrote the screenplay, I realized that the tale of this character reminded me of Job. Of course, we didn't tell the story of Job, but that was the starting point.
Если я правильно его понял относительно священника, который разговаривает с Николаем, он там нужен нам не только формально для того, чтобы напомнить нам о том персонаже в истории.
En ce qui concerne la conversation avec le
As to the conversation with the priest,
il ne nous sert pas seulement à raconter l'histoire de Job.
It helps us to tell the tale of Job at that time.
Равновесие или фигура, которая уравновешивала бы нашего архиерея.
C'est une figure qui permet de
This character creates a balance in what we show and what we say about the Russian Church. You have the bishop and you have the simple priest.
Так и понимает Бога.
Et qui, comme il le peut, comprend le Seigneur.
And he tries as best he can to understand the Lord. He talks about God in his own simple words. He's a man with a very deep faith, a very simple, pure person.
Он изъясняется, как умеет, чем может помочь вот в случае с этим диалогом, вот в диалоге с Николаем, тем и помогает.
He explains things as best he can, and he tries to help Nikolai.
Как мне казалось, не фарисей, а человек
искренний.
He was not a Pharisee.
Именно как некая, что ли, чаша весов.
He's a very sincere man. That's very important to have this balance. Thank you.
Jeffrey Wells, Hollywood Elsewhere. People drink vodka in this film the way most people on a hot day drink lemonade. Speaking as someone who used to drink, this doesn't strike me as alcoholism per se. It strikes me as alcohol insanity. And I was just wondering, is this particular to this village, or is this, as much as the film is, reflective of Russian society as a whole?
Thank you.
Вы знаете, с вами бы согласился министр культуры Российской Федерации. Я не иронизирую, я просто под большим впечатлением от встречи с ним. Мы показали картину господину Мединскому. Вот, и, пожалуй, одно из вот первых, что он сказал, что в России так не пьют. Это был тоже его такой
взгляд. That it's quite amusing to see that the Russian Minister of Culture, when we presented the film, said, well, we don't drink like that in Russia.
Можно было бы переадресовать этот вопрос Алексею Серебрякову, потому что он главным образом у нас фигурант по этому делу.
I think we could put the question to the actor himself, because he knows, and he confirms that he knows.
Взять бутылку водки, взболтать ее, превратить в воронку этот напиток, опрокинуть ее и вылить до дна, даже не закусив. Есть такие герои в наших пространствах. Винта.
There's a Russian sport which consists in taking a half-liter bottle of vodka, shaking it, and as soon as it whirls around, you drink the vodka without even eating anything at all.
Следующее. Я бы, конечно, не хотел, чтобы вот эти коллизии, значит, с винтом и с водкой ассоциировались с тем, что Россия
это и есть водка, это не, это совсем не так.
Je ne voudrais pas du tout.
Alexei says that people drink just as much in Japan. I wouldn't like people to have the impression that Russia is vodka.
Спастись от той вот пустоты, которая обрушилась на Николая.
Mais comment Nicolas aurait-il pu essayer d'échapper?
Nikolai can't escape the horrible situation he finds himself at the end of the film.
Merci, monsieur, s'il vous plaît, là-bas.
Thank you very much, and I think I love this film very much. It's already my personal golden palm. Yeah. My question is, for me, this film, the mayor and the whole political system, like the monster, Leviathan, like this name. But your film, I also noticed, is supported by the Russian Ministry of Culture. So. My question is, how can you do it? It means you have the total freedom for your production. And by the way, when I travel in Russia, Russian people, they don't drink too much, but they force me to drink. It's very interesting. Yeah.
Не только.
Ну, в общем-то, могу сказать, что я могу сказать на эту тему? На тему свободы. Но если ты не свободен, то если ты не чувствуешь, что, в общем, все временно, если у тебя нет ощущения, что главный твой долг и обязанность говорить правду, говорить то, что ты видишь, отражать ее и говорить языком открытым о том, что происходит.
In terms of liberty and freedom.
Я не думаю, что здесь мы можем говорить только и исключительно о России. Я думаю, что человек, столкновение человека и государства в той или иной степени во всех концах земли и одна и та же проблема.
I think that in all countries of the world, all around the earth, the problem of liberty is important. It's the duty of everyone to combat the state, to uphold liberty.
Либо говорить максимально открыто и свободно, честно.
Ou bien on parle de ce problème, ou bien on ne parle pas du tout de ce problème, ou bien on en parle.
Either you don't talk about the problem at all, or you address the issue in a very honest, frank, forthright manner.
На днях к встрече с министром мы с ним поговорили после картины, и надо отдать должное, что, как я его интерпретирую, он сказал так, что картина талантливая, но мне она не нравится. Он имеет, конечно, право на то, чтобы ему не нравилось,
might like это нормально. To talk again.
Я даже понимаю, почему, потому что у него какие-то другие задачи. Задачи сделать мир лучше. Ну а что должен делать министр культуры и власть? Так ведь?
So as I was saying, I'd like to talk again about this discussion with the Minister of Culture after he saw the film a few days ago. He said the film was very talented, but he didn't like it. I can understand that stance. He has a lot of other work to do. He's supposed to make the world better.
Он автоматически переносит на вопросы искусства. Мы выступили исключительно и только на территории искусства. Мне кажется, вы согласитесь с этим. Конечно, острый фильм, но он вообще об уделе человека. И не только русского человека, и не только на территории России. Вот так мне кажется.
In fact, one can understand the Minister of Culture. He has to go about his political work, and he is Minister of Culture. He deals with art in general. What we are doing is to create a work of art. So we have other concerns.
Mr. Rodnyansky, you want to add something as producer?
Let me add a few words. Actually, this movie has been supported by Ministry of Culture and Film Fund in Russia. I believe around 35% of the budget was provided by these two state institutions. And even more, there was a public pitching organized by Ministry of Culture where we won the subsidy from them. And I believe this is pretty good example of what we can achieve in the country where we have a great artist with a strong idea and, as we believed, a beautiful script and, you know, ability to express themselves in a convincing way. So we'll see how it would be received in Russia. Definitely, we expect this movie to be challenging. The reaction would definitely be mixed, but at the same time, we believe this movie has an ability to attract the Russian viewers, to make them laugh and cry.
And do you know already when the movie is being released?
It's very much up to... No, generally we have a plan to get it released in September already.
Okay. Thank you. S'il vous plaît, madame.
Allô, j'étais en train de parler en français, mais if you speak English, maybe that's better, if it helps you to speak, because this is to the actors, as well as the director, as well as the producer. So this is an enormous film. It is amazing to see this here. There have been a lot of films about, well, a lot. There's been films touching Chechnya, Syria, Ukraine, Maidan, here, in and out of competition, mostly out of competition. So this is an enormous privilege to see such a film. And there is great dimensions and textures and layers in this debate. I wanted to ask, out of the metaphor, how does the artist in Russia live today? There is absolute futility. C'est inutile it's useless to go against authority. That's what you show in your film. And you show suicide. You show people just giving up and their lives have been destroyed. So now, what is the reality today for you? Do you recommend filmmakers and artists to leave and to go to Surrey, England, where I also live? Oh, by the way, Madeleine was from the Press Association in Paris and also Frontline Club in London. Does the artist in Russia go in exile where they can say more, or can they stay within Russia to express such absence of a protest and futility of the regime?
Ну, послушайте, вот мы же высказались, и не то чтобы у нас была цель в какой-то конфронтации с властью или с правительством, вовсе нет.
Our goal was certainly not to confront power. Particularly considering that the film got financial support from the Ministry of Culture and the Cinema Fund.
Вообще, у меня была первая встреча с ним. Я увидел человека, который слышит.
In fact, I'd like to talk about the meeting I had with the Minister of Culture. I noted that he was reasonably open. He could understand certain things. He obviously has a firm position, a firm stance, which cannot but be respected, because he has a specific goal to reach.
Что автоматически он переносит свои представления о том, что должно служить человеку, как бы на вопросы искусства.
So I'd like to repeat what I said earlier on. Art must provide light. It should be a form of enlightenment, and it should give people hope.
Люди, которые как-то смотрят на это по-другому.
But there are people who see things in a different way. And I'm very pleased indeed that my film received financial support from the state. I have great hope.
На то, что они понимают, что, знаете как, пусть растут все цветы. Мир многообразен, на него нужно смотреть с разных сторон. И я надеюсь, что понимание это есть.
I do indeed hope that we will reach mutual understanding. I do indeed hope that freedom will prevail in the world. But I wouldn't venture to give people advice. I do, however, firmly intend to live in my country and to continue making films.
Excuse me.
Позвольте мне как артисту сказать, а не как режиссеру.
As an actor, I would also like to take the floor.
Артистом в России, потому что играл бандитов всегда.
I became a famous actor in Russia because always I've always played the part of a bandit.
Таких противопоставления с государством.
Et très souvent vous des bandits qui étaient bénis en quelque sorte par le pouvoir.
Bandits who were blessed by the powers that be often. And as you can see, I'm wreathed in smiles, I'm quite attractive.
Художник. Ну, художнику всегда везде, в общем, есть где жить, есть где поработать, есть что увидеть, что услышать. И нет здесь, ну, государственные границы не играют никакой роли.
I think that a person who devotes his life to art always has work to do, wherever it may be. I don't believe that borders are at all important.
За себя я думаю, что я надеюсь, что такими картинами, которые мы сейчас вот снимаем,
I hope that films like this one will make the world a bit better in our country as well. Nobody else wants to answer the question?
Madame, s'il vous plaît.
Go ahead.
I'm from the New York Times. I want to continue with the line of questioning. It's a wonderful, strong, and universal film, but I wonder if things have changed in Russia since you began making the film, and are you concerned about any negative consequences or particular fallout now? Are you worried about how the reception by the Russian government might affect your ability and your liberties as a filmmaker in the future? Thank you.
Где здесь бар?
La question posée, c'est et où est le bar ici?
The question was, where's the bar here?
Смотреть как-то там вперед, бояться чего-то, каких-то перспектив, нерадужных каких-нибудь там изменений.
Penser à l'avenir et avoir peur, craindre des difficultés.
Thinking about the future, feeling afraid, worrying about future problems. I think you have to take things as they come.
Те, кто поддержали его. Я говорю сейчас о Министерстве культуры.
Le film est fait.
The film has been made.
Donc cette œuvre, il a été présenté au ministère de la culture.
It was presented to the Ministry of Culture, which gave it financial support. And for the time being, everything is absolutely fine.
Я понимаю, что я не отвечаю на ваш вопрос, но ей-богу, мне больше нечего сказать.
I may not be answering your question, but that's what I wanted to say. The film has been made. The film is there.
Я прошу прощения, если не ответил на ваш вопрос.
I apologize.
Это не бегство от ответа. Просто мне нечего сказать.
I'm not running away from your question.
Мы запустимся с ним. Я не вижу никаких препятствий.
We have further projects, and we certainly hope these future films will be made. I'm sure there won't be any obstacles.
Сказал ему, что есть еще два, как минимум, замысла вполне себе интересных и очень таких бюджетных и серьезных. Он сказал, приносите сценарий. Они открыты, скажем так. Я так это вижу.
And 2 days ago, when I spoke with the Minister of Culture, I said to him that I had two projects which I hope would take shape, and he answered, well, show me the screenplay, and we'll read them. There was a quote from the Minister of Culture in an article published by Le Monde. He said, all flowers can grow, but we'll only water the ones we like.
Добрый день. Игорь Гуськов, Европа Плюс, Москва. У меня два вопроса. Первый вопрос. Андрей, когда вы работаете над сценарием, над историей, вы уже видите актеров, которых вы будете приглашать на роль? А второй вопрос ко всем актерам.
The first question concerns the choice of the actors. When you wrote the screenplay, were you already thinking about the actors who would play the various parts?
Второй вопрос к замечательной группе, команде актеров. Как для вас сюрприз, не сюрприз, когда вас Андрей Звягинцев позвал в фильм? Что это для вас? И работа в фильме?
And then there is a further question.
Мы не слышим пока актеров. Мне очень хотелось, потому что актеры звучат.
Поэтому я отвечу очень коротко. Очень коротко.
The second question is for the actors.
Никакого представления о том, кто будет играть какую роль, не было никогда.
Whenever I write a screenplay, I have no idea what actors I'm going to choose.
Мы начинаем встречаться с актерами, и тогда и происходит вот это.
When the project has been launched, then I start meeting with potential actors. The second question was for the actors. How did the shooting go? How was it working with Andrei? It was a great pleasure to work with Andrei again. For me, this is a very important character to play. The topic's very interesting. The other actors were outstanding. And I'm happy.
Алексей? Звягинцев позвонил. Алексей, donc je demandais à monsieur Звягинцев. Алексей Севряков, je dis Звягинцев, vous avez appelé et...
So, Andrei called you up, and what happened then?
C'est uniquement grâce aux efforts de mon épouse.
It's thanks to the efforts made by my wife that I ended up on the set, because she convinced me to accept the part. I knew that Mr. Zvyagintsev is not an easy person to work with. For him, filmmaking is more important than life. And for me, it's the opposite. That's why we're deeply different. We don't agree. And that is no doubt why I didn't meet the Minister of Culture either. I must admit, quite frankly, that I'm absolutely thrilled to have acted in this film, because Andrei is fanatically dedicated to the cinema and also he's very kind and aware of other people. He feels for people and he really tries to help them. I made many suggestions during the shooting, and they were all accepted. Work was not easy. Drinking vodka for 3.5 months non-stop is not at all easy. Of course, I actually drank water during the shoots. I don't think anyone, even a Russian, would, or even Alexei Andrei, would be able to drink vodka day and night. We actors haven't yet seen the film, in fact. This evening, either we'll be horribly disappointed or we'll be thrilled. We finished the film over 6 months ago, and we've been waiting ever since to see it. Today is a very, very important day for us. Although this is practically the end of the festival.
Здравствуйте, товарищи.
Bonjour, camarades.
Hello, comrades.
Я хочу сказать о том, что Андрей как бесконечно талантливый человек.
I'd simply like to say that Andrei Zvyagintsev.
Потому что как только если этого нету, значит рядом находятся люди те, которые не должны этим заниматься. Вот так как Андрей как стержень.
When you make a film with Andrei Zvyagintsev, who is an extraordinarily talented man, one has equally to show talent. You are caught up in this talented whirlpool, so to speak.
Признаюсь честно, я шел, я знал Андрея только по его работам, лично мы не были знакомы.
Jusqu'ici, je connaissais les films de Zvyagintsev, mais je ne le connaissais pas personnellement.
Knew about his films, but I hadn't met the director personally, and I was very pleased indeed and deeply flattered to have been chosen by him.
Мне всегда везло на хороших и талантливых режиссеров.
I've been very lucky in life with the directors with whom I've worked. But quite frankly, quite honestly,
Вот знаю, там в мире, в Европе, думаю. Ну сейчас.
Donc, il se disait, Andrei Zvyagintsev a déjà reçu beaucoup de
récompenses. I'd like to say that Andrei Zvyagintsev has received a lot of awards and prizes at various festivals. Maybe he'll be too sure of himself, too pretentious.
Тоже 40 с лишним лет в кино.
Et puis moi, ça fait près plus de 50 ans que je fais du cinéma.
I've been appearing in films for over 40 years now. And I also said to myself, well, I'd like to go to the Cannes Film Festival too. In fact, I came here with another film in the past. I was a bit anxious.
И мы встретились с Андреем. Взглядами я понял, что здесь все будет в порядке.
But in fact, when we truly met in person, I realized that there would be no problems whatsoever.
Общались, поговорили по поводу нашего как бы образа, персонажа.
We talked about the character and the film together.
Наигравшись в российском кинематографе огромное количество бяк, коррумпированных милиционеров.
I have often played the part of a corrupt cop, a corrupt policeman in Russian films.
В этих образах предложить что-то новое.
And I wonder whether Andrei Zvyagintsev would offer me something different.
Получаешь сценарий, ты понимаешь, что ты играешь опять коррумпированного, неважно кого уже.
Because every time I get a script, I know it's going to be another corrupt person, be it a cop or a policeman.
Надо сказать, что Андрей сделал несколько как бы предложений, которые действительно показались очень интересными.
I must admit that Andrei made me a number of very interesting proposals. It's true, it was difficult. But the overall impression is positive and full of joy.
Людей, которые знают его уже много лет.
He has a crew, a team he's known for a very long time. And everyone is always prepared to work with him as soon as he asks. Everyone got along extremely well. Everything went beautifully. Like a Swiss watch, it was very smooth.
Куда приплывают киты с поразительной энергетикой, тундра, которая...
You can see the whales approaching the coast.
Это просто тканный ковер совершенно невообразимых красок.
The landscapes are extraordinarily beautiful. It's hard to put words to it.
Где ты снимаешься на фоне фотообоев каких-то? На фоне тундры сняли, я говорю, клянусь, тундры.
In fact, when I put the first pictures of the landscapes on Facebook, people were totally surprised.
Нам предстоит очень волнительное мероприятие. Сегодня все артисты будут...
That is why, believe you me,
зрители смотреть... ту работу, которую мы сделали.
This evening will be very intense for us. We'll be very watchful spectators. Thank you very much.
Madame, s'il vous plaît.
Sorry, I'm Catherine Shaw from The Guardian in London. Congratulations on the film. I wondered, I understand... Thank you. I understand there's legislation proposed in Russia at the moment to ban swearing in cinema and books. And I wondered if you had any thoughts on the wisdom of that and whether it would affect the release of Leviathan.
Ну, насколько я знаю, закон подписан. О ненормативной лексике, о ее неупотреблении на сцене, в литературе и в кино.
The bill states that there should not be any swear words stated by actors during films. Nobody.
No.
The text has been signed.
В силу вступает закон 1 июля.
Mais comme cette loi entre
But as this law will enter into force on the 1st of July, if the law is actually implemented,
право выпустить картину такой, какой вы видели ее вчера.
Nous devons avoir
а
le
мы
droit de justement de présenter ce film.
We should be entitled to screen the film as it was shot before the 1st of July. I don't think we use too many swear words in the film. Each word was carefully weighed. We wondered whether it was necessary to use this or that word in the dialogue, and each word was carefully chosen. I just think that this is a very lively way of expressing oneself.
Я считаю, что тут нужно как-то избирательно подходить к этим, вопросам.
Ces mesures d'interdiction me paraissent.
These laws that ban things aren't very suitable in my eyes.
На постере написано: осторожно, ненормативная лексика. Вот уже договоренность между участниками этого. Здесь это было необходимо.
In the film, it was truly necessary to use this kind of language and these swear words. Last question, madam.
Спасибо. Марина Тарапыгина для «Вечерней Москвы». У меня вопрос по поводу, вернее, вопрос скорее к Михаилу Кричману. Андрей рассказал, как получилась история. Мне бы было интересно узнать, как вы работали над изобразительным решением этой истории. И, может быть, в процессе работы появились какие-то изменения. То есть как взаимодействовала идея и образ в вашем фильме?
La question est adressée au
the question is for the chief of photography, Michael Kritschmann. In light of what the director has said, how did you solve the problem of lighting?
Работать с Андреем – это всегда трудно и всегда удовольствие.
Working with Andre is always difficult, yet it's a pleasure.
Образы рождаются в процессе прочтения сценариев, в процессе работы над сценарием режиссерским и в процессе создания фильма, съемки.
I think that everything is put together bit by bit. First we read the screenplay, and then we gradually go about our work during the shooting.
Фильм претерпевает изменения несколько раз. То есть со мной это как минимум три раза. Это сценарий, работа над сценарием, впоследствии с Андреем и реализация.
First of all, we did the screenplay, and then I work with André on the screenplay and work with him during the takes.
Вы, собственно, находитесь на тех рельсах, по которым движется поезд, который уже не остановить, и, собственно,
as soon as we're on the set, the film is on the right track, and then we just work ceaselessly. The choice of the lighting came naturally. I think we'll stop there. We'll now end the press conference, and thank you very much.
Merci à vous.